guys! Today I'm here to talk about the fourth month of the pregnancy. I'm trying to catch up here on the videos of the pregnancy, so let's see how the fourth month was. Okay, so first thing, I'm gonna start talking about the symptoms, what I said about the first trimester, what I still had on the fourth month, what got better. Definitely by the end of the first trimester, things start getting a little better, but for me that happened a little slower. Like on the first 2 weeks, I think, of the fourth month, I was still having all the same symptoms, so I felt like I was still in the first trimester. I was still feeling nausea like every day. I was still feeling very tired, very sick, so I was like, oh my god, this is never gonna go away. But on the third week, definitely start getting better. Like, I wasn't feeling nausea every day anymore. Like, a few days, definitely, I was still puking a few days, but it wasn't like every day anymore. So I would feel like better for 3 days, and I would get all happy that I finally it's gone, and then after 3 days I would still feel bad and I would still puke and all that, but it's definitely better than every single day all day. So by the end of fourth week, I was like getting sick 2 or 3 times a week, but not every day, which already helped me a lot. On the energy thing, I started definitely having a lot of more energy, but not completely, because since the second month of the pregnancy, I've been having a lot of insomnia, and that's common with me. I have insomnia on and off my whole life, but definitely got worse with the pregnancy, like almost every day, which was bad because I was like feeling sleepy and tired all day during the first trimester, and when I could actually sleep, I wouldn't. I would just have insomnia and I would stay awake, which would make me more tired next day. And then you would think like, oh, after a few days of that, you're definitely gonna sleep. That's what it was in my mind, but no, it didn't happen. I would have insomnia every single day. So during the day, what I was doing is like, some days I get like very, very tired during the day, and when that happens and I can, I'm free and all, I just sleep through the day. Not through the day, just like 1 or 2 hours, and that definitely helps me, but that doesn't happen like every day. It's just a few days of the week, not even a few days of the week. On the fourth month, I think like 1 day of the week. People say that the second trimester is the best one, and I can see that now. Definitely I have more energy, I feel more like myself. Still a little tired because of the insomnia thing, still a little sick a few days, but definitely feel a lot better. Also, on the video of the first trimester, I told you I'm having a lot of blowouts. My skin is really bad with acne and all, and that's still the same. Seriously, I didn't have a skin like that since like I was 15 years old, so that's very awkward for me. I definitely don't like that part. I keep like wanting my pregnancy glow. Where is my pregnancy glow? Definitely have no glow. I have like really bad skin, and a lot of people say that that happens sometimes with a lot of women, and that goes away at some point. And for me, it's still not that point. I hope that happens soon, but so far I still have a lot of acne. I think I didn't have like any real cravings on the fourth month or in the first trimester as well. I said I didn't have cravings. I was having a lot of nausea, so it was actually very hard to eat. When the nausea start getting like a little better, I start eating way better for sure. So I finally start gaining a little bit of weight. I think of the fourth month, and the first trimester I ended up like losing a little bit of weight because I wasn't eating that much and I was vomiting and all. But on the fourth month I start finally gaining some weight. I think I got like 2 pounds, so it wasn't like a whole lot, but it's actually something. And I was really eating way more than on the first trimester. Still a few things I can't eat, like for some reason I wasn't being able to eat chicken at all. Now that I'm on the fifth month, I tried again just a tiny bit and I could eat it without vomiting, which was good. But on the fourth month, I still couldn't eat it. I had aversion to chicken, from chicken, like since the beginning of the pregnancy. And on the first month, 1 week, I was feeling like really good for a few days. So I was like, I'm gonna try again. And I ate it, and then I ended up puking it. So I was like, okay, no, not yet. maybe this baby won't like chicken. I don't know if there's something related to that or not. But I was still like, I still couldn't eat a lot of things, but I was eating way more, and so ended up being better. Actually, like by the end of the month 4, I was feeling hungry like every 2 or 3 hours. I can't eat a whole lot every meal, but I was feeling hungry like way more often than I used to. And also another thing that happened on the 4th month was that I finally had to buy some maternity clothes, because it was getting hard to use my own clothes. I feel like my bumps like growing really, really slowly. So I'm gonna show a picture of how my bump was by the end of month 4, which is not like a big bump, it's like just a tiny one. But my boobs got way, way, way bigger. Like I lost all my bras. I had to buy new bras because none of my bras were fitting me anymore. And also I think I got wider. Like I have this feeling like that I got way wider, so my hips got like larger. That's how a way to describe it. So I lost like all my jeans. All my jeans wouldn't fit me. A lot of shirts. I lost a lot of clothes. They were not fitting me. So I had to buy, especially pants. So I bought like long pregnancy jeans and a few shorts, because here in Florida it's hot, so I use shorts more than the pants anyway. And a bunch of leggings, because leggings is like easy, always comfortable, it fits me nice. So I bought a bunch of leggings, and then 1 jeans and 2 shorts and a few dresses. That's what I bought so far, but it's helping me. I don't want to buy like a whole lot of pregnancy maternity clothes that I'm not gonna use forever. I don't know, maybe I'll have to buy a few more. But so far that's what I got, and I'm trying to use like the stuff that I already had, like this one that's loose, and then I can still use them for sure. Another thing that happened on the 4th month was that we finally found out the gender of the baby. That happened actually on the beginning of the month 4, because we did the NIPT test. That was something like funny, because we did it actually on the end of the first trimester for the first time, and they couldn't do the test. Like I took the blood, and then I got the message that it was a low fetal fraction, and that freaked me out for a little bit. I was like, oh my god, is there something wrong with me? Is something wrong with the baby? I freaked out, and then I talked to my doctor about it, and he said probably they didn't get like enough blood or something. They did something wrong in the lab, and that I shouldn't worry about that because everything seemed fine with me. So I try not to freak out anymore. I waited 2 weeks, and then on the beginning of the month 4, I went again and I did an NIPT test again, and that one went well, and it was, all the bad stuff was negative, which is a relief. And then we found out that our baby's a little girl. And we did a gender reveal. The video is already here on the channel, so if you didn't watch that, I'm gonna link down below for you. And after that, I could finally start buying like a lot of baby stuff, because I was waiting to find out the gender. Actually, I bought a few things before, and I got a few things before too, so more like gender neutral stuff. And after that, I like went crazy and I started buying a lot of cute clothes and all for our little girl. In the nursery, we start like working on it, but like slowly, like we're gonna turn what was the guest room in the nursery. So what we did on the month 4 was like emptying the room, and we turned our office and office/guest room all together. That part's done, so the room is definitely empty, so we can start working on the nursery now. But there's nothing on it so far. It's basically like an empty room, but that's something already. And I guess that's it for the month 4. I don't know if I forgot something. If you guys have any doubts, you can ask me and I'll let you know. And I feel like by the end of month 4, my feeling was like trying to catch up, because on my first trimester, I think like I was too slow, I couldn't do things, I was like just quiet all the time and feeling sick and feeling tired, and I didn't do much. And I feel like now I have to catch up in life to, like, I don't know, prepare the house, prepare for the baby, and personal stuff too. So now I'm really excited. We are actually going to Brazil soon, so I'm really excited about that, and I'm gonna tell about it on the video from the month 5. Maybe I'm gonna do vlogs, I still don't know about it, but probably. So stay tuned here on the channel and you're definitely gonna see the news. And that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Bye bye.